let's kill your Maya vaccine virus for free. Hello, I wanted to make a quick video about this vaccine virus in Maya. I decided to make a video because before I went on a hike, I saw that there is a paid script out there, and even though that might be useful for someone who doesn't have time to fix it, I wanted to let you know that there is a free, manual way that you can clean your computer and the files and get rid of the virus completely. So how do you do that? Let me go back to the computer and I'll show you. So here we are in Maya. Let's start with what is the vaccine virus. You want to save, and then we get this strange warning. And that's how we know we are infected. And then you're thinking, perhaps if I save as a different version or a different file, but still same warning, because now we are infected. So this warning is the indication that we have the vaccine virus. So what is the vaccine virus and what does it do? It basically infects our scenes with two script nodes, but it also generates some files. So usually you will find these files in documents, Maya scripts, depending on your installation. But for me, it's documents, Maya scripts. And here I see some files, user setup, vaccine, and vaccine, PYC. You can see here the path, but generally you should search the computer for these files. So with all files, you want to open them with a text editor. Notepad will do. First, let's talk about the user setup. You can choose to delete it, but sometimes other scripts use it and they have some lines in it. I would suggest just deleting those lines generated by the vaccine virus and keeping the user setup. But it's up to you. If you don't need it, you can delete it. I just wanted to let you know that it's possible. So here I'm double checking if I saved the file after deleting the lines. And as for the vaccine files, we can just select them both and delete them. And that's it basically for the generated files. Let's talk now about how to clean our Maya files. These are generally the lines that we have to look out for and delete in the text editor. So how do we find those lines? We simply open our .ma file with a notepad or any other text editor. Find those lines. Here I press Ctrl F and search for the word vaccine. And then I just select the lines, delete them, save the file, close it, and that's it. Our .ma file is now clean and our file isn't infected anymore. But as many of you already know, there is no way to do the same with the .mb file. When we open it, we see this crazy code. So let's jump in and I'll show you how to clean an .mb file. So first of all, I will open a new clean Maya scene. Then as always, we will head up to File, Open Scene. And here we want to make sure that we don't want to execute the script nodes. So here we want to really make sure that we have this option unchecked. The execute script nodes should be unchecked. Then we select our .mb file and hit open. Now, once we open our infected scene, we want to head up to Windows, Animation Editors, and Expression Editor. Now, to see the script nodes in the scene, we need to go up to Select Filter and select by script node name. And here we can see that our scene has a breed zine and a vaccine zine, and we can simply select each one of them and hit delete, and then simply close. Now I save my scene, and you can see I get no warnings. Let's talk about how can we prevent Maya from opening an infected scene. We can head up to the Autodesk App Store and download security tools for Autodesk Maya. Here, you will need to choose what your system is that you're using Maya on. For example, for me, it's Windows, but you have to log in first. We have to sign in to our Autodesk account. Just hit download, save. Once it's done, open it, install now. And this shouldn't take too long. So once it's done, close it. And now you can open Maya. And once this is done, we can finally head up to Windows, Settings and Preferences, Plugin Manager. Then you want to scroll almost all the way down until you find this, Maya Scanner. Now you load them and select Auto Load so it runs every time you open Maya. And that's it, now you can close it. And the next time you want to open an infected file, Maya will give you a warning. So I'll do this quick test. And remember, if you have a reference that is infected, you have to clean that too, because it will affect everything again. And yeah, that's it. Boom, done. And you didn't have to pay anything. Amazing, right? The licenses are expensive enough and there's no need to pay anything extra. I mean, you can do whatever you want, but I would suggest spending your money on important things. I'm here to help and provide some value if I can, and who knows, maybe even save you some money. I will be doing similar videos in the future from time to time, so you might want to consider liking and subscribing and all this fuss. But for now, that's it. Thanks for watching, stay safe, stay creative, and keep animating. Bye.
Hello, I'm Alex.